Buenos días a todos. My name is Kostas Diamantis Balaskas, and we are from Greece. Our organization is the coordinator of the Roma TNT project, and we, together with the Panhellenic Association of Greek Roma from Athens, we have also been that is possible for implementing this project in Greece. I will tell you just two main things about the project, and then we will pass to Mrs. Natasha Balaska, who will make the presentation of the methodology of the project and to what we have done practically in this preschool that we have created. So the objectives of the project was to develop and test a model for the organization of preschool centers, nursery schools, especially designed for the Roma children of a preschool age that will prepare them to be better prepared to integrate in the school environment, because we have found that one of the main reasons for a low performance of Roma in school education is that they don't have proper pre-school education in many countries. This was a 12-month project, and it was for the first time the first call for projects for education for Roma that was specially from the DG Education and Culture of the European Commission. It has started last April and is finishing now. These schools, we had some principles. They were centers to function as nursery schools for the Roma children of preschool age. The activities of the schools were supervised by two intercultural intermediators, one teacher that was non-Roma and one Roma intercultural intermediator that were together in the class. The focus of the activities was the preparation for the school. These were near Roma settlements in order to facilitate the access of Roma children to the preschool. Breakfast or lunch, depends on the time, were provided to these children. And the activities were developed on the basis of best practice, and we exchanged best practice in the participating countries. So we had this model. We have these preschool centers running for 6 months, and there were at least 20 children in each country. And also we have organized training for intercultural intermediators. There are four countries that participate in the project: Greece, Spain, Hungary, and Italy. And the partners, we the Panhellenic Association of Greek Roma, PER, here, Maranatha, Association of Gypsy Organizations from Spain, the former State Foster Children's Association from Hungary, and AMIS, which is the Association of Intercultural Mediators in the Health and Social Care Sector, from Italy. These are our contact details, and we pass very briefly to the presentation of the methodology of the Roma TNT project that we have implemented and the Greek experience.
I'm very pleased that we are here, and we have the pleasure to present you the work that we have done within the project Roma Teaching and Training. As Kostas says, it was one of the first projects in the framework of lifelong learning projects. So 8 projects were actually selected, and though the duration of this project were very brief, only 12 months, I think we have try to fulfill all the objectives of this project. So I will present you the methodologies. So this is our class, actually. and our teacher and our intermediator. You can see them all here. I will start by explaining the characteristics of methodology. The teaching methods and activities were such in order to allow the children to develop their personality, to socialize and become aware to the human-made and natural environment. The communication, interaction and presentation of data by different means, so we have used different approaches, crafts, drama, drawing, tables and diagrams, and technology, tape recorder, camera, computer, etc., assisting the learning process in an interactive and multisensory way. Language has, by definition, an interdisciplinary, interthematic characteristics, since oral communication, reading and writing are associated with all issues approaches. The syllabus emphasize on the process without neglecting the importance of knowledge required and produced by the processes. The activities proposed were indicative, since some resulting from current everyday events and from the children's interests. So the role of the preschool teacher. The teacher, what was the role of the teacher? The teacher has created the right condition with an attractive, safe and friendly environment, rich in stimuli, in order to ensure optimum motivation and learning conditions for the children. Organize intriguing learning experiences that were meaningful and interesting for the children. Supported the learning approach through the means of playing, exploring, exploiting different sources of information, discussions. Seek the participation of each child in the daily activities and took advantage of its existing knowledge and experiences. So, as always, a school, the role of the teacher is very, very important. The teacher mediated and facilitated the entire learning process. So what we have selected our partnership, it was to implement the inter-thematic approach. The program also was organized around themes of interest and was pedagogically appropriate for children. The activities developed were collective and favored interaction, communication, the use of technology, the reader and oral speech. Which are the fundamental concepts? It was the interaction, the dimension of space and time, communication, change, that change will support them to their evolution, similarity, difference, culture, and system. The work plan were research subjects chosen by children. The goals were individuals and collective. The activities were developed to stimulate participation, initiative, cooperation, creativity, and dialogue. Emphasis was also given in working in small groups. Again, our classroom. So, what are our motto? Our motto is one school for all. So, we don't use different pedagogical approaches. Our objective is one school for all, but using different learning paths according to our needs. Here you can see again the class and also the president of PER, who is here with us, who has visited the school and to monitor how the school activities are going. The preschool syllabus was divided in two parts. One was a pedagogical framework and preschool syllabus principles, and the second was the teaching areas. So, preschool syllabus. The emphasis of the interthematic approach of knowledge, the experiential learning and the organization of experience that makes sense to the children of that particular class. The development of the subject matter, topics and the work plans. The recognition of playing as one of the most important training frameworks. The emphasis on cooperational learning, the integration of ICT, the use of formative evaluation for the organization of learning and teaching, as well as the follow-up of children's progress. So we had, in the framework of our second transnational meeting in Bologna, we have a teacher's training, and there we have discussed which subjects could be appropriate and as indicative, as I said before, for the training of the children. So 12 subjects were treated and teached in the class. It was my name, that's me, personal health, my family, food, my school, my work, environment, transportation, means of communication, my feelings, knowing a writer. So, during the piloting phase, the teachers followed the proposed methodology and teaching areas topics. So it was first organized and teaching training in Bologna, and then they were organized in each country, so in Spain, in Greece, in Italy, in Hungary, again, a teacher's training at national level in order to train the teacher and the intermediators of the methodologies that will be implementing in class. The core of the training process was shifted from the child, which discovered the knowledge on its own, to the classroom community, and the acquisition of knowledge. Promotion of dialogue between the teacher, the child, and its classmates was one of the most important teaching strategies. Here you can see a photo of a teamwork in class with an intermediator. Actually, we have the team, it was a teacher and two intermediators. One working in class with the children and with the teacher, and another who was bringing the children in school and discussing with parents. So, piloting in Greece. The premises that we have used in preschool center was fully equipped kindergarten classroom, and where we have organized the class, it was in a region in Athens, in the school of Anna Lyosha. So the classes was 4 times a week, evening classes. The students were about 15-20 Roma students, and the age was for 4 to 8 years old, because we have seen that a lot of children have never attended to the schools, and we would like also for older children to give them the opportunity to familiarize with the idea of going to school. Our teacher's name was Antigone Zaku, and our intercultural mediator was Vangelis Karagounis and Nektarios Alexis Ains. So our teacher played an active role in class. Her supportive as well as leading role in class was emphasized. And while the intercultural mediators also played a very important role during the piloting. They not only made sure that the children attended class by bringing them to the preschool center, but they also assisted and helped the teacher in class. They had daily contacts with parents. All these facts were supported, of course, by the Roma Association that was a partner in the project, by PER, by the Panhellenic Association of Rome. The teacher provided daily journals, not only describing the learning topics and the everyday activities that took place in class, but she also presented the difficulties she encountered, it, as well as the methods she adopted to overcome them. The diaries also contained evidence, photos, etc. Here again is our class. Here you can see the other intermediator. In addition, prior to starting a new topic, the teacher provides how it is organized, a lesson, a pedagogical plan. So for each topic, the teacher provides a lesson, a pedagogical plan, followed by a pedagogical report. So in the pedagogical plan were described the pedagogical ways that she's going to use to implement the specific topic, what activities are going to be carried out, and then after she has implemented this approach, we have received a pedagogical report for each topic covered in class. The pedagogical report described in detail the pedagogical methods applied, the learning objectives in every single topic, whether these objectives were achieved, the difficulties encountered, and how did the teacher overcome them, the children's reactions, responses, the pedagogical materials, resources used, etc. This project is for teachers' training, so all this material will be available in order to support not only these teachers, but also other teachers that they would like to work with Roma children and generally in a multicultural environment. So all this will be available in learning. So our methodology has a theoretical part, and then after the piloting, we have a practical part. All this experience will be available for the teachers and intermediators. Here we can give you an example of a diary. So each day we have the teacher was writing a diary about how the lesson was in the class, and she was starting by saying, today at the beginning of the lesson we dealt with the routines. Routines was also a very important part of this methodology. So every day they were discussing about certain topics, about the weather, about daily things that they were important for the children. And of course, more important aspect of that is to learn behaviors, how they have to behave in the classroom, so to prepare them for the kindergarten. See in the diary, she has described what materials they have used, what are the subjects they have talked about, and also the paintings that they have done, and after the painting, what other activities they have carried out. So this is very helpful and very practical for the teachers. So now you can see some photos from our activities in Greece. You have also the chance to see also for all the other countries. This was the first day in class, so we have organized Christmas party. Also book reading event. So a writer came that writes children for books for children. Visited our school and spoke with our children and sang with the children and read them books and gave them books in order to familiarize with the idea of reading. The children were very excited about that. See, they're waiting and they thought that it was very important to see a writer from very close. Here you can see also some crafts, dancing, and class corners playing, because it was very important also to the class to have different class corners where the children they can play there and they can put in practice what they have learned. Thank you very much. Great.